Welcome to another impromptu video, and a little late, but happening anyway. Per usual, when the seasons change, I tend to go duck hunting. It's a week late because when summer happened, it happened to also be the day that they had leagues, so I couldn't do it, and then work became a problem. So, a few days late, but we're doing the seasonal thing. Collins Bowladrome, Billerica mess, and we're gonna go duck hunting. And of course, the ducks here are extremely lazy and stupid. They just sit there, and they don't move till big round buckshot hits them. Question is, how will it go? How will I make the ducks scatter? Let's find out. My high is a 118. Which sucks compared to candle pin and 10 pin. And the low is surprisingly a 65, which is kind of high, being how the other two are really bad as well. Enough yapping, let's start bowling. Cross camera. The deadwood. And then we got a piece still there. And we start the seven. And that was to clear away a piece of wood that shouldn't be there. Finally, and a lovely six. And these balls are only a quarter inch bigger, but they're almost 4 pounds compared to 2.5. It doesn't seem like much, but it's making a difference. It's too far right anyway. Nice. I don't like how off one of the pins are, so I'm going to throw a few balls down there and reset. Doesn't help that I hold 18 candlepin games on Saturday, and it's Monday, so I'm a couple days removed from it. And another six. Time for the halftime report. As I mentioned, the high here is 118, low is 65. We're heading towards the low. Nothing good except for that nine for 34 at the half. All right, I don't like where this camera is, so I'm going to move it a little bit. There we go. The Duckpin version of a half Worcester right. And the first state frame of the day with a four. best we can do is 9. Oh no, it's still there. It counts. Afraid if I tried to remove the deadwood, it was going to take out a pin. It didn't, so the 8 stands. Heading for a new little score, another 4. And you see what I see? It's the head pin a different color. You know how this works. If I get a strike, which we know how things are going, that's not going to happen. TNC Bank and Trust in Fitchburg will pay us 25 cents. Can we get a strike? I thought the 65 was a bit high for a low score. Well, this corrects it. And there you have it, a brand new low score of 64. Isn't that wonderful? Wasn't game one a blast? Let's see how bad number two goes. Better start. Thank you. distinct frame of four. Who knew that was going to happen? You know what that means. It's time to throw El Stinko the bonus ball. The way things have been going, it's probably going to suck. Let's see how much or little of a bonus we get. Not bad, a seven. Halftime report. Much better. Still nothing impressive. 46. And a Duckpin Billerica. Sherman is setting the four pin wrong. It's a little too much that away. Thank you. made on the spread duck wings with the short wing on the left. There we go. Spare. And for scoring purposes, because duckpin is considered easier than candlepin, averages, I believe, are 10 points higher. So 80 is mediocre, 90 is good, 100, average ability! Which I believe it's, yeah, they say if you crack 100, you're doing good for a casual bowler. And then better from there. So this is my worst discipline. Or actually, it might be 10 pins still. I don't know. And since I did not pay attention and completely did not pay, forgot what the bonus ball was, I'm giving myself the zero penalty for it. And a 9. Since it's no record or anywhere near it, I don't care. I probably did break triple digits, but I'm not willing to review. I'm not paying attention. I just take the hit. I know I got more than... I know I've hit stuff, but... Again, I'm not going to bother checking. I didn't pay attention, give myself nothing. 98, much better. Let's see what game 3 is like, and hopefully we keep our eyes on things and remember things. Thank you. was aiming for the 8 pin, not the 10. Still didn't get it. It's an 8. Sherman pin setter proving yet again that it's a bit too rough on the pins, so another reset. Seven. And for the halftime, the seven's the worst of it so far. No marks, 42. It's nine. Seven. Eight. 7. And a 6. The second ball just barely stayed on the lane. Duck God's middle finger for 9. Alright, this video's getting a bit long. I don't trust the phone's ability to continue on its own. I've let it happen, and it corrupted that particular segment. 2 9s, that's pretty much it. Just broke into mediocre territory with 80. Stop and start, and we'll be back. And we're back. So far, only one good game. Just proving that I suck at pretty much every bowling, except candlepin. That's the only one I've really improved at. Well, let's see how this one goes. A Duckworth for an 8. That was dumb luck. A 10. And we have spread duck wings. Thank you. a 7 out of 10. My Sherman, aren't we just a bit rough? I figure if I rolled that ball slow enough, it would get that piece of wood out of there without doing anything. 7. That were only ball 2. Still, it's 10. And here's the halftime report. The 10s, 8's okay, 7's meh, but at least it's still in a mediocre territory with a 42. Somehow, this and Candlepin seemed way different to me. I was getting so much better at that, I'm not getting any better at this. Quick on that button, didn't need it. That was a decent shot for a spare. Time for El Stinkin' the Bonus Ball, and this time we pay attention to the bonus. We did on the first one. El Stinko delivers a split and a mediocre five. Thought it was going to be Curse of the Fill, but we had seven. It is. Again with the Duckpin Kaleri left with the four Duckmen and the nine. Broke into good territory just barely at nine. Alrighty. Because they say 100 is a good game for the casual bowler in duck pins. They do the 10 fudge factor, meaning 90 is good, 100, great, well, 110, great, and 120, a miracle. 90. All right, let's see what game five is like. I think I'm warming up. Again, it probably doesn't help that I threw 18 games of Candlepin 2 days ago either. Sherman didn't give us a head duck. And there's my worst stink frame of the day so far, and an awful start of two. 8 it is. Why we wait for the ducks to spin around. It took out another pin, but it left us the 7-8. This is by far my worst game. Probably won't be when it's done. Momentum. Still in there. Narrowly averted a stink drain. Half time. We are tied for the worst game. 34. 2 8s and a 9. Well, the 2 stunk it up, really. If we keep things up mediocrely, we might hit that territory. I was about to throw a ball to clear that pin, but I didn't notice the conveyor belts weren't that far down. Another 8. Thank you. 8. Just enough weight and just barely enough size. I can't control the damn things. No. Gamers on the 6. Well, another crappy game, but it ended better than that did. 74. I tell you, I guess I'm not big enough to make the transition between candles and ducks. Can barely hold the ball. They're heavy enough, they're slipping out. I just suck at this. Since I told you I suck, I'm not making excuses. Anyway, let's see if 6 can be any good. Gotta love them Shermans. Gonna stop and come back in a moment. And we're back. The jam has been cleared. the king duck stands by itself for now. Eat again. King duck again for now. Déjà vu. It's time for the halftime report. We're on our way towards a mediocre game. 43. Nice recovery for him. Now. Second and near miss of the night. Again, a pin where a pin should not have been. I got even a six. Gutter ball, no good. Push the wrong button. That's it. Thank you. Again, if that were just ball two. 10. Stink frame of three. And we're 1 point away from the lowest game, which is now the new low score. 8-8-10. Then the 6-3-35. Again, this thing just does not like to give me good pins. See if we can get a set of pins that's good. Collins joined the Zero Club. No, six. Oh well, again, I didn't pay attention and did not finish game six, so consider it a fail. Thank you. And to end the game with a crappy leave, the spread duck wings. I swear there's gotta be something wrong with me, because where is it? I didn't pay attention and forgot what that was, and I forgot to pay attention and don't know what that is. It's been happening more and more often. The 6 is the worst thing. Still, a 77 is craptacular. Let's see what 8 has in store. Stink frame of 4. I'm wondering if it's more like too much emphasis on one thing and not on another. Thank you. The Sherman thinks it's a Bowlmore. That's the first one. Let's stop the camera. Getting sort of mediocrely close towards that 4 gig thing anyway. Well, things can't go bad enough, right? Why not just pour on the failure? Why not? And for the halftime report, we are heading to a new low score again. A couple of okay eights, 33. And the duck god's middle finger for now. Thank you. spread duck that got messed up pretty bad. I'm surprised I got a 10 from that. Yeah, it looks like my ability to do things in bowling is slipping. Take a look up here if you can see it. I can't even count to 12 without messing up. That was 10, 11, 12, and then realize it ain't adding. Anyway, another sucky game. So for those of you saying I'm not sucking at anything, well, here you go. Duckpin, the ball I cannot control. 76. Let's see how bad 9 goes. Looks like Sherman decided to give us the special head pin, and you know what that means. If we get a strike, and we know that's probably, I should say, that will never happen. Not today. 25 cents from TNC Bank and Trust. Ooh. Again, if that were only ball two, 10. Frame of three. Yeah. Two sitting safe for eight. Although not as bad, it's still flirting with a potential new low score again. A 3 and a 6 hurt. 36. Duckpin Kaliri left before Duckman and Lanai. And 7. Yeah, the Dale head pin, 25 cents. TNC Bank and Trust, not gonna happen. New will come in, stay tuned to it. Done up there. Mm-hmm. And this is going down as one of the worst outings ever. 9-8, that's it. 68. Game number 10. Will we reach a new low score again? I'm not worried about the 118. I don't think we're getting anywhere near that. Good out, 9. Seven. Halfway to Worcester on that one, if that's a thing in ducks. The hole for 8. Well, a little short of mediocre, but we could get there. The 5 is what hurt it. Otherwise, the 10, 9, 8. 7 kind of stinks and ducks. 39. somehow the 7-pin went down. We got a spread duck wing with a couple of short wing. Wasn't gonna make its way in around anyway. That's annoying. At least I got an 8 out of this. That was a throwaway. 8. Last frame, I need 8 for mediocrity. Crap a mark. Who knew that was a thing? Alright, at least it's a mediocre game, and we gotta fix what Sherman messed up. Still waiting to see what El Stinko the bonus ball will give us. And Sherman screwed up again. Hopefully it'll just take out that pin. Damn it! Still El Stinko to bonus ball. Still waiting for a set it'll give us. That's good. Any moment now. It was worth the wait.
An eight.
I think I'm concentrating too much on things because as I think about it, there's other aspects of life and gaming in general that even short term is not having difficulties with, so might be over-competitive, I don't know. Trying to explain away why I don't remember what that is, or if that should be down there, don't matter. And the fact that I forgot what that fill was. Anyway. Here we go. El Stinko did not stink, gave us an 8. Made it into a good game, barely, a 90. It's almost 6 o'clock, game 11. Time to wrap up the dozen. Well, this is 11, not 12. Better start than a strike. You know what that means? Two El Stinko the bonus balls to hopefully not forget. You gotta pay attention to things. El Stinko number one. Second one can miss, it's still a good fill. That's an 8. Special pin remains for 9. Thank you. for the halftime report. The strike saved us. And as you might notice, for those of you that play Duckpins, the score sheets look weird because here in Massachusetts, they tend to make them in candlepin formation. We also use the candlepin notations for strikes and spares. Hence why that might look weird to you. 50. And we have four Duckmen left, and actually in somewhat good line this time. Again, another it could have been a ball two moment. 10. I was willing to take the risk for a 9 there to get rid of that wood. I don't think the sweeper would have got that. Didn't see that one until after the fact. It would have still been a 9 anyway. Was dumb luck. Who would have saw a spare coming out of that? Time for L stinking a bonus ball to hopefully get us into average ability, which is 100. El Stinko didn't stink. That's a 9. Nine fill in a 10. Last frame, I only need 2 to make average. Average. this frame and the last were wish they were ball two moments. Another 10. Alrighty. Ooh, that thing's getting dangerously close. 10's 9 fill on that, 10 from the frame, and another 10. Average! 108, and probably the only average game we got. I don't like where this number is. We're going to pause and start. I might show the score again just in case it went over and corrupted. We're back. And in case it corrupted, the end, that is, we got a spare with a 9 fill, which then became a 10 in frame 9, and another 10 in 10 for a 108. The only average game that's probably going to happen today. Otherwise, they're all mediocre or suck. Or, well, I think there's a couple good ones. Let's go. I guess we can say there is a very minute possibility, or remote. Yeah, they both work. 25 cents from TNC Bank and Trust. Risk it. It's that pin's far enough back. First of many missed pins on that. And a half Worcester at the duck pond. Oh. good shot for 10. Getting to mark the places where I've beat the low, which occurred today. Hooray! 9 and 7, the only ones where pins were missed. 46. Take 7 after that. Momentum on that pin. We have the 4 Duckpin left. It's not as close as it looks. Two frames left, 10 away from mediocrity. And there's the 10. Thank you. Now, if that pin were there just before this frame, 25 cents would have been mine. Two El Stinkos. Pin for El Stinko number one that lives up to its name. El Stinkos deliver with a 3-4 fill. And just like last time, it ends very badly. Curse of the fill, it's a foul. And this day of disasters ends with El Stinko, the bonus balls, both living up to their name, adding up to a mere 3, and then Curse of the Fill only getting 5 for an 88. It was a disaster the whole day. Game 1, brand new low, yay, 64. Game 2, 98, 3, barely broke mediocre with 80. 4, 90, 5, 74, 6, did not add it, so consider that one a fail. 7, 77, 8, 76. 9, almost hit the low again, 68. Then things got better, 10 with an okay game of 90. Average on number 11 with a 108. And a mediocre 88 at 12. Well, I don't get it. Candlepin and Duckpin are supposed to kind of translate. They just don't. Balls are just heavy and big enough that I have absolutely no control over those things. Sort of came back in the end, but still. Anyway, that's an impromptu from Collins Bowladrome in Billerica, Massachusetts. Georgia551 saying, hope you enjoyed, especially at my expense, and proof that I still suck at bowling. I just got better at candlepin. And that's probably going to stink for a while now that I did this. Anyway, have a good one.